One of President-elect Trump's signature campaign promises was to repeal and replace Obamacare. So how would that affect the millions of people who are covered by Obamacare? Dr. Ezekiel Emanuel is one of the architects of the Affordable Care Act. He's currently the chair of the Department of Medical Ethics at the University of Pennsylvania and a former advisor for health policy to the director for the Office of Management and Budget at the White House. Doctor, great to have you here.
Nice to be here.
For the 20 million people who are covered by so-called Obamacare, what happens to them if it's repealed and replaced?
Well, if it's repealed, they obviously will lose their coverage. And the big question is, what would you replace it with? I will remind your audience that for 6 years, the Republicans have been trying to come up with a replacement bill. They've never actually been able to put a replacement bill out there. They've never introduced a replacement bill that's coherent. They've had lots of ideas, but those ideas don't actually get you what they want, which is everyone with a pre-existing condition can get an affordable health insurance package. And you get coverage for everyone.
They say they would hold that. They would keep that element.
But here's the irony. You can't keep that element. Getting people with conditions, insurance, that they're guaranteed at an affordable price without a mandate. And they don't like
Why?
The mandate.
Help Zeke remember. One of the problems in selling this is that it's so complicated.
Healthcare is complicated.
So they say get rid of it because everybody's premiums are going up. You can't keep your doctor. It's not as promised. We can do better. You're right. Saying that there's a big hole in the second part of that statement. Why?
Right. Well, first of all, they haven't ever given a proposal that's done better. But here's the issue. If only sick people get insurance, right, then the prices go up, as we've seen.
Because it's more expensive to treat those people.
That's what we've seen, right? So you have to get everyone in. Now, to get everyone in, healthy people, young people, 25-year-olds, we've seen this with Obamacare. That's part of the issue going forward. You actually have to force them to get in. It's called a mandate. You have to say you have to have health insurance. If they don't come in, if you don't have coverage for everyone in the country, then you will not be able to guarantee people who have pre-existing conditions their coverage at an affordable price. Their proposal, which is high-risk pools, super concentrate the people with sick conditions and give them incentives to buy insurance or subsidies to buy insurance, that is a very inefficient disaster. For 3 million people, right, it costs $25 billion, according to the Congressional Budget Office. That is not a good deal. And so they have a contradiction. That contradiction in their proposal has never been able to yield a coherent alternative. That's the replace. So if you don't have a replace, you just repeal, 20 million people are going to lose their insurance. I don't think they actually want that headline, yeah. Because some people are going to be harmed by it, and then you know what's going to happen. You'll have stories of people who had coverage under Obamacare and lost it.
Obamacare was one of the things that animated the anybody who was against President Obama.
Correct.
They felt that it was being shoved down their throats. They never believed his promises that if you like your doctor, you can keep your doctor, that your premiums are going to go down. And in fact, it did not live up to some of its original promises. I know that you were one of the architects of it, but you have to admit there were some, it did not deliver on all the things that the president said it would.
I disagree with that. And let's dissect too. First of all, there's no doubt that the PR around the Affordable Care Act was not good. The administration did not do a good job of selling it to the public. That's separate from, has the Affordable Care Act done a good job for the country?
Yeah.
The fact is, if you look at the data and you compare the increase of health care premiums under George Bush to those under Barack Obama, he has slowed the rate of growth tremendously, saving people thousands of dollars.
So even though Zeke, not as much as they would have, you're saying.
That's right.
Right, but hold on a second.
And that's very hard for people to understand.
And here's why it's hard for them to understand. Because
Believe
there's me. Sticker shock. Put up to some of the states. Arizona, 116% increases. Alabama, 58% premium increases. 14, 40.
Sir, 12 states, including big states like California, New Jersey, Michigan, are actually under 10%. Some states are even cutting their premiums. Massachusetts had a decrease in the premiums. You didn't cite that, interestingly enough. We can both cherry pick, okay?
But I'm saying, why are they so much higher there if that's working?
That's a one-year increase, and they're higher for the reasons we just said. We have a difficulty of getting young people to buy insurance. The mandate, many people think, penalties weren't high enough. You didn't really have people get it, and the banding, the ratio between what young people pay and old people pay was too narrow at 3-1, should have been broader to lower the premiums for younger people who we needed to get in. Those are the two problems. But that's a one-year adjustment. Remember, the exchanges opened with premiums much lower than anyone expected. So they're coming back to what people expected. They're not going super high.
So your dream is that it be fixed. These things be whatever, be fixed, but right. Not obviously repealed.
Right. Over the previous months, I've been writing of the kinds of, you know, 3, 4, 5 things you could do to fix it. No one, when we passed the bill, thought it was a perfect bill. We knew we'd have to fix it. This is democracy. You're not going to get a perfect bill on the first time. Plus, over 6 years, we've seen other problems. That doesn't mean that overall the bill hasn't been a big success. Healthcare inflation, the rate of growth of increase, has come way down in the system. Now, it's true, drugs are going up way too high, and we have to fix that. But the overall system is actually getting better. We're actually improving substantially. So we've had 20 million people getting coverage. The rate of cost increase has come down. And quality, by the way, has gone up. Infection rates in hospital and other things have come down.
The irony is,
that's a big success. The irony is the public doesn't see it and thinks it's a bad bill.
And that's because perception is reality. And the way that this got passed,
you said that before.
The way that this got passed, which was forcing it down the throat of the Republicans, really engendered an animosity.
That is not true. We had meetings all through 2009 with Republicans, the Gang of Six, the Gang of Eight, the Gang of Four. We were negotiating with Grassley, with Brasso, lots of other people. They never came to the table with an alternative.
So you wound up cramming it down, and now they hate you for it, and they're trying to take it away from you.
There are many reasons, and again, I think the publicity around it was a mistake, but that doesn't mean that the bill has not been a very big success and improvement on the American healthcare system. And again, let me just put it out there. The Republicans have never had a credible alternative that they've been able to pass. It's easy to repeal this bill. It's not going to be easy to find a credible alternative. And the idea of we're going to solve everything by having insurance companies sell across state lines, that is not a solution. That's not a healthcare reform plan that actually addresses the issue most people want, which is the pre-existing conditions and the moderating of costs.
And it will take bipartisan support in order to get the fixes that Zeke and others are talking about.
Dr. Emanuel, thank you
thank
for being
you.
Here on New Day. Great to talk to you.
Well argued, Doc. Appreciate it.
Well,